Stay here is still echoing through the camp. It's only been hours since the return of the 12 spies, but in moments, the excitement that had been building for a month quickly crashes down to pure despair. And the people sit, only for seconds before a deafening cry of agony breaks out. A mother, silently sobbing, jerks back her tears to hold herself together. She places her hand on her child's cheek, attempting to capture every memory of the feeling of smooth baby skin. But the look on her face tells the whole story. The fear in her eyes is almost tangible as she looks at her son. It's every mother's worst nightmare. Her child's life. Her own life. No, the risk is too great. They cannot go forward. This land may have been promised, but she did not sign up for a cost this great. And you can see the thoughts start to form. Their old way of life becomes more appealing as the promise actually starts to cost something. Maybe they can go back. Maybe the mistreatment wasn't as bad as they thought. And maybe bondage isn't the worst life sentence. It's better than the price of moving forward, and at least they would have enough food to live. And she isn't the only one thinking this, because the whole camp starts to murmur at each other. Parents and adults now synonymously agreeing on one thing: take us back. And the murmuring turns into begging. Take us back. Slavery over freedom. Comfort over promise. Take us back to Egypt. The cost is too great here. For if we move forward, we may die. But if we stay here, we will die. If we go back, at least we might live. Take us back to slavery.